Now we come up with the anomalies of the spinal cord development. These are one mark question answers. Please note down. These are one mark question answers. We come across to the first terminology. Write down the spelling correctly. Rachisciosis. R-A-C-H-I-S-C-H-I-S-I-S. Rachisciosis. What is rachisciosis? One mark question answer. Whenever the neural fold will not complete its folding, whenever the neural groove will remain open instead of folding and development of neural tube, then it is called rachisciosis. Incomplete closure of the neural fold or incomplete closure of neural tube will lead to the formation of rachisciosis. Second terminology. See, these are very frequently asked. In rachisciosis, same way here, we will write down myelocele. Please write down correctly. Myelocele. What is myelocele? One mark. Question answer. When this rachisciosis affects the spinal cord, it is called myelocele. Or in other simple terminology, when there is incomplete closure of neural tube in the region of spinal cord, it is called myelocele. Third terminology. When the same rachisciosis affects the brain, it will lead to anencephaly. Anencephaly. What is anencephaly? When there is incomplete closure of neural tube in the brain, brain remains exposed to the outside. Or you can simply mention that whenever there is the defect of neural tube closure in the region of brain, it will lead to anencephaly. So rachisciosis, which is present in the cranial most structure affecting brain, will lead to anencephaly. Then we come to spina bifida. This I have discussed earlier with you people. Then also it is mandatory to mention it here in the developmental anomalies of spinal cord, spina bifida. Now this spina bifida, by definition, this is the developmental anomaly affecting the vertebral column. The vertebral column, the lamina will not close posteriorly, as a result of which the lamina of vertebral column will remain open posteriorly, which will lead to this defect, spina bifida. Now because of spina bifida, spinal cord will be affected. So therefore, there are various cases which are related to spina bifida, and what are they? That is worth mentioning here, and therefore that is the need. The first, it is called spina bifida occulta, O-C-C-U-L-T-A, occulta. Now this spina bifida occulta, what is spina bifida occulta? One mark question answer. It is that in cases of spina bifida, there will be no defect in spinal cord, only there is bifid spine posteriorly. So that there will be presence of only few tufts of hair which are present in the level of, at the region of lumbosacral region. So because of the presence of these few tufts of hair, it is called spina bifida occulta. Basically there will be no defect in spinal cord, it will be completely normal, except presence of those few hair follicles. So it is called spina bifida occulta. Then we come across to second very important terminology, and that will be the meningocele. Not myelocele, but meningocele. Now in meningocele, through the bifid spine posteriorly, through the spina bifida posteriorly, there will be herniation of, protrusion of pia mater and arachnoid matter. So pia mater and arachnoid matter, they both, the layers are protruded outside, and therefore it will lead to this condition which will be known as myelocele. Not myelocele, meningocele. Meningocele. Only pia mater and arachnoid matter, meningocele. Then the third condition we come across to. In the third condition, there will be, this is a very huge condition, so it will be known as meningomyelocele. This is called meningomyelocele. Now in meningomyelocele, what will happen will be, along with this meninges, there will be complete herniation of the spinal cord and its nerve roots. So spinal cord and its nerve roots are lying within the cystic swelling, which is present in the dorsal region where bifid spine is there. So in the dorsal region, cystic swelling will contain the entire spinal cord and its nerve roots along with the meninges. that will lead to a swelling posteriorly, which is covered by a very thin friable membrane. So it is called meningomyelocele. One mark. Again, another one mark question, which is also frequently asked, will be this meningomyelocele will lead to one syndrome which is known as Arnold-Chiari syndrome. Arnold-Chiari syndrome, C-H-I-A-R-Y, Chiari syndrome. So this Arnold-Chiari syndrome, what is Arnold-Chiari syndrome? One mark. In meningomyelocele, there will be, sometimes it is accompanied by herniation of spinal cord from foramen magnum along with some part of cerebellum. As a result of which the level of foramen magnum will be blocked, as a result of which there will be hydrocephalus present in the ventricles. So because of accompanying hydrocephalus, this will be known as Arnold-Chiari syndrome. So meningomyelocele along with hydrocephalus, because of the herniation of small segment of medulla oblongata and cerebellum, will lead to Arnold-Chiari syndrome. And then we come down to another syndrome, and that syndrome will be known as syringomyelocele. So this is known as syringomyelocele, S-Y-R-I-N-G-O, syringomyelocele. So this syringomyelocele, what is syringomyelocele? Meningomyelocele plus collection of fluid within the cavity, where the central cavity will be dilated, it will lead to syringomyelocele. And then we come to a very rare anomaly, which is known as anterior spina bifida. This will be exactly opposite spina bifida. Anterior spina bifida, where non-fusion of the two halves of the vertebral body, where in the anterior region, median region, both the vertebral bodies will remain separate. So it is called anterior spina bifida. Very rare anomaly. And it may be accompanied by herniation, protrusion of the spinal cord. So here we end the anomalies of the spinal cord. Thank you very much.